Hello, everyone, all who are one body of Christ. Our Savior welcomes to the two, let us give this together. Today, we're meditating upon acceptable worship. Before we start, let's see if Scripture talks about this topic. Psalm chapter 51, verse 16 to 17. For you will not delight in sacrifice, or I would give it up. You will not be pleased with a burnt offering. The sacrifices of God are a broken spirit, a broken and a contrite heart. O God, you will not despise. Now, too, we can learn from the verse we just read. We can gain a practical understanding about worship from the story of Cain and Abel, first recorded of worship of doing something and receiving an acceptance from the one who has worshipped. It's the stopping your normal routine and intentionally doing something for the sake of worshiping the Lord. Second, it is offering something. Both Cain and Abel brought an offering to the Lord. In the same way, in our culture, we should give something to the Lord. There is so much that we can give, time, money, energy, our lives, and etc. Third, we must worship, which is pleasing someone. This is what was set the worship of Cain and Abel apart. The offering Abel gave was received with favor. It was acceptable to the Lord and met the standard that God had set. We can go through the motions and do the things that look like worship. We can give to the church, to others, and to God. However, just because we do these things, it isn't automatic that we are pleasing God. A popular song says, "Well, you search deeper within, through the way things appear. You're looking into my heart." A true worship is deep inside the heart. A true worship is how I live my life. So when people see me and my actions, they see him, and all I do projects his glory to glorify his holy name. A true worship is what we do in the workplace, at school, at home, when you go out. When we do things which glorify his name, we please him, and he will receive our worship like Abel. This message also gives us a promise today. The promise is, for whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will save it. Let's close time in prayer together. Please join me in this prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, mighty, wonderful God, Lord, be with me to teach me to do the true worship which will please you. Lord, give me wisdom and a humble heart so every action in my life will become an action of pleasing you by glorifying your name. I ask all this in Jesus' holy name I pray, amen. Have a blessed day, everyone. If God's going to talk to you tomorrow.